Hi, my name is Gerhard Schwarter. Welcome to Selling Power TV. Today, we have the great pleasure of meeting with Dr. Sharon. She is the author of a new book called The Authenticity Code. Welcome, Dr. Sharon.
Oh, thank you so much, Gerhard. It's awesome to be here with you today.
What got you interested in authenticity? Because it's a really big topic for salespeople.
It really is, Gerhard. And I've been doing leadership training programs for the past 20 years. When we do our programs, we used to call them executive presence and presentation skills. And when I started to really ask participants, what are you getting the most out of this program? They said authenticity. I feel like you've helped me to discover your, you know, my unique gifts and talents, who I truly am as a leader and who I want to be as a leader. So that's what we were hearing. And then as I listen to the millennials out there, they're like, we care about authenticity. And I said, well, I've got a program that is giving that to people. So I said, this is really the authenticity code. And the code is your presence plus your audience plus your presentation equals your success. And if you can crack that code to really become your authentic self, it's going to help you to sell better, make a bigger business impact, and land the job you really want.
I feel that in everybody, there's a little bit of a tension between the authentic self that wants to come out and the critical self, where people are too perfectionistic.
Yes.
They're never satisfied with the way they show up. What advice would you have for those people?
We have to be mindful of the internal blocks and critics that we have inside ourselves. And I have found that videotaping yourself, and also that we videotape in our programs, all of our professional and leadership programs, and help people to watch it back in terms of how are you coming across? And to really help people connect with their unique gifts and talents, I think that can then overcome a lot of that internal inner critic, we call it.
So what is the recommended process for becoming your true authentic self and feel comfortable with that?
Well, it is all laid out in my book, The Authenticity Code, and I wrote it as a parable of two sales professionals that are competing for an associate director of sales position in a company, and how they have to learn on the journey about how important their presence is, knowing their audience, and also their messaging. So there is a whole process laid out, and in the back of every chapter, there are tools that you can apply to your own career. One of them that is critical that I will say is to really get in touch with your authentic brand statement. And I have 10 questions in the book that if you answer, you will draft who you are and who you're becoming as a professional and a leader. And what are your unique gifts and talents to give the world? And in your audience, you have to also know, how do I tailor to my customer that I'm in front of, or my client, or who I want to make this sale to? And there's tools in the book that allow you, how do you tailor your message and size someone up to know, are they a people person? Are they more of a point person or a planner person? And you can really then gear your messaging to that person or to those people. And I think that's so important as well.
The word presence also has to do with the present moment.
Yes.
A lot of people focus either on the future or on the past and forget that life is happening in the present moment. How do you focus on the presence?
If you really identify your authentic brand statement, I recommend keeping that next to you. And you read it in the morning. I read it every evening. I read it before important meetings to remind myself, who am I? How do I want to come across in this meeting? It helps you to stay centered in who you are. We also have 12 authentic presence qualities that we've done research on, and that people who express these 12 qualities are more authentic.
I want to point something out to you that I observed about you.
Okay.
Which is you, when you speak, you use your hands, and then you emphasize words with synchronized hand gestures. And I noticed that in many successful people that they have a way of presenting their ideas, not just with tone of voice, but also with very subtle synchronized body language.
Thank you for noticing that. And that is actually in my book under the your presentation part of the code, because it's not only do we have a clear presentation, do we have great PowerPoint charts, but what does our nonverbal communication say about ourselves? With so much virtual happening today, we have to know where to look when we're doing an interview. We have to know how to use our hands. Our voice tone is so important as well. All of those tips are in the book. And so thank you for noticing that, Gerhard.
When you look at the, you know, for example, Richard Branson, can you think of other leaders that have impressed you with their presence?
Like Sheryl Sandberg, I think, is a great example. The woman in Facebook who wrote Lean In. I think her presence shines. Absolutely. Martin Luther King Jr. I mean, he's in my book because he has set the stage for a movement in our country. And you will notice that all of these people that I've mentioned, they care more about serving their audience than about looking good themselves.
Well, thank you, Dr. Sharon. I love your book, The Authenticity Code, and I recommend to anybody who wants to have a more authentic and more meaningful existence, go to Amazon.com and get Dr. Sharon's book.
It's available on pre-order, and we're launching it October 19th.